Good morning and welcome back. So, let's continue working on the safe game. But first, let's see what we have so far. Even though there's not much to see for the something to show, but we have safe game file here. It's created when we save position, transfer, and stuff like that. Inventory, equipment, all just that needs to be saved. And the last thing I added was the character data. And then we save the game. And we also add the save game name to our save game list, name list, which is not really a list but an array, but it's okay. And we can also load this. When we load the stuff, we are deactivating the exploration triggers that we already found. And we are removing the collected items. And for that, I'm saving a list. Of item names, array of strings. And thank you for the auto hosts, by the way. So, we have one thing that I need to fix here because I added another save game. That's saving config files later, but at the moment it's just saving the list of save games. But for some reason that's not really saved. Hello. No, I don't. No contact at all. But what you could try is tweet at them. Maybe they can help you. Yeah, here we need to check if the config save actually exists. And luckily for us, there's a note for that. Sorry, not 100% the awake yet. So this is game config save. And if that's true, then we load our game from that slot, and if it's false, we create the game. Create save game object. Config save. Here we do. This cast. Collapse the true macro. This here as well. Let's see if it works now. Oh, and let's just add something else here. In the main menu, string that we have here. Okay, this is completely empty. So let's create a new game. just run around, pick up a few objects. Talk to this guy. Let's quit this game, and if we click quit, it will be saved. If you want to resume, then yes, okay, now we have the test player here. Okay, so now it works. That's what was the thing I didn't get yesterday. Let's see if the loading works. Yeah, it works, but we still have the bug that when I jump between game and main menu too many times, at some point just get stuck. Not sure why. Let's see. Maybe something's not completely unloaded and it's causing the problem. But there's another thing I need to figure out. Why is the resume menu visible in the background? Set to hidden. That makes sense. Okay. Better if we make this bigger. And I also need to fix the button display here. Let's do that now. is invisible. The button itself. Okay. Looks good. Better. Okay. That's strange. Why is that empty? Really strange. Okay, and then also need to change something else here. We don't need to print the names out. Worked, so we don't need to do this every time. Okay. Should get rid of the character data. Character data. Okay, I'm doing it here again. Gone. Okay. Not really not sure why that not that's not working. Let's quit here. Set this somehow. Oh, yeah. We are loading it, but we are not overwriting the list here. So that makes sense then. Still doesn't work. File looks like. Okay, this is overwritten here. Yeah, I think that's the problem here. That we shouldn't do this. I kind of killed the save game. I mean, the save game is still here, but we can't really load it because it doesn't know the name. Some names here by hand. Let's see if we get those. But I'm quite sure it will override them here. Need to save this properly. So let's do this. just to fill in some data, we need to create the file, and then here we are saving it. Because it does find it, so that's... Quit now, and then... should work. Let's see. Okay. Now we have some saved slots there. Let's see if it loads that game. Okay. But there's some kind of data missing here in this one. Yeah, the journal is not saved correctly, and we might have other problems. That's the first save game with character data in the background. Okay, we have the journal, we have inventory. See if we can pick up the same item again, if that worked in the safe. No, it's not here. Okay, that worked. So let's... delete this one and delete this one. Though this will be overwritten anyway now. Which means at some point it might clutter up the UI there. With a lot of save games, if you use too many of them. But I mean, we can just delete the save game and then it will be recreated. Okay. No more save games. Yeah, but this will not load. Because it's not there. Just deleted all the save games here. Okay, so it's starting a new game. I mean, it's good failsafe. Behavior tree seems to be broken for some reason. And I need to make these bigger because for some reason text is cut off here. And we need some kind of background for this because we can't read the text down here. Okay. I mean, okay, we didn't save the game now. Damn it. Save game works. So let's fix some bugs. Even though it wasn't really a bug, but just UI that's not designed correctly. Inventory item list. Okay, it's not here, but on the parent. Yeah, and this looks horrible. Some image to this. this one. Yeah, this doesn't really have a background. This one has. See if that is slightly better, but I need to redesign this whole thing, I think. Yeah, I didn't save. Yeah, but this is better now. Here we have a background. Though we need to add a bit of margin in here for the text. Yeah, and these need backgrounds. And I need to fix the buttons here. Let's save this game. Okay, let's go here and fix that button. And I need proper graphics for this anyway at some point. Could do something else. Let's see. Okay, now we have a bit of background here. Oh, I wanted to fix this here. Let's exit. books fell through the ground. Don't really like the image here. Let's clear that. Content in here again. mean, this whole thing was kind of designed after the Skyrim. Inventory, so it kind of looks like that, even though I kind of like the base functionality of it, but there are a few things that I don't like about this. I mean, I don't need much information here. That's and the item display here is just, what do you call it? Yeah, just because I can do it. It's displayed. It's There's real stylistic and gameplay idea for this, so that's why it's there. Not sure why this button is darker than the other one. Oh, because this draws it's none. Okay, now I know why. So if you go here yeah, here we have the inventory image, but let's see. Inventory screen. Skyrim. Yeah, that was the original, and that's the reworked. Just definitely better design wise. Let's see, I think I have some icons for this here. See, maybe we can create that. textures, UI textures. Okay, they are black, so, but we could use them at least for some of it. Yeah, now they are just clothing pieces. I definitely need to look into getting some icons. Sprites for my UI stuff. But the ones that I have, have a few problems. Yeah. I mean, they work. I like them. But to get the tiling right, it's a bit of a problem because here we don't have straight lines. I mean, this works, kind of, but this doesn't have a kind of darkened background. Yeah, this one also has no darkened background. I mean, we can work with that. Let's see. Let's close those. And oh, it's the items itself. Not items themselves, the category button and item and list. Hello, how are you? Game's good. Progressing. Yeah, and here I need to think about what this would look like. Let's see. This would be. Change that? Yes. Wait, did it change the? What's the name? Vertical box item types. widget. Let's see what this looks like. The books are gone again. No, I didn't create the font. The font is an old font that was part of an old Unity package. Let's see, maybe you can find it. I change that? Or remove it? Strange. I saw this, it was Necromancer. Yeah, here it is. That's the complete UI package, and the font was part of it. It's what I was using for some of my whole UI on the Unity version, and I ported that over, and it is in here, but the problem is that the this window thing here is not really scalable that much and doesn't look that good. There's something here that we can use. Okay, those are textures. Yeah, here we have a lot of icon packs. I think at some point I just need to invest in some icon pack and then be done with it. Yep. Okay, this partially works, but the problem is that if the text gets too long, it doesn't fit anymore. So I need to replace the text with icons. Let's see. Yeah, and I have for the books, I created this one. Here I'm using the window, but like I said, it doesn't scale that good. And the other problem is that for the book, I actually want to have kind of a book where I can flip through pages and stuff like that, so that it's not really scrolling here. If we open up the level, why is that? It's an old version of the same map, but it's always coming back. Every time I delete it, it's coming back. Show why. Why does this always happen? Why don't you like my mesh I give you? Stupid thing. Take the text in the middle. Not sure what you mean. Here. If we click on read, then we get this book overlay. But the problem here is that using a scroll bar here and don't like that. Want to be able to flip through pages, but the problem then is that I need to kind of change pages and stuff like that, so not quite sure yet how to do that. Kind of separate the text out in different pages and stuff like that. Or I need to limit the amount here. Now the bump is showing up again. Sometimes it doesn't show up correctly. Strange. Yep. Unreal Engine. Yes. I think some of the information in below the stream is still says something about Unity, but moved on from Unity. Why are these textures not showing up correctly? It's strange. Can I delete them? And in the journal is also the same screen as the book. And I want to have the same thing here, even though I'm thinking of maybe having some kind of side part here with just the dates and then only one text here. Not sure yet. So that you can kind of click the date and then you get the journal entry for that date. So that there won't be a list, a scroll thingy here. But that might not work for the book. It's showing the real complete bump map. Normal, not bump map, normal. Strange. Okay, and this book looks horrible because it doesn't show up correctly. Yeah, that could be it. But the thing is, I want to change this anyway at some point. I want to change the textures kind of more to yeah, not use textures but materials, and in the materials just use the create something in the material editor without using textures. At the moment, I'm working on my inventory screen. I want to fix that somehow. I use wooden border thing here. Items in the list as well. I mean, here they are just using a
kind of a list. And if we have all of them, then it shows an icon in front. Then we get additional information here. I mean, I don't have damage or weight or stuff like that because I'm not working on an RPG, but I wanted to create a similar looking UI. Small. Let's just have a look at this. Yeah, that's kind of what we had before. But this is the old our original UI for Skyrim, which I didn't like much. But I followed a tutorial to create that. Thank you for the host. And kind of wanted to use something similar to this. Let's see, maybe we can create something that looks like this. So, first let's remove that image. Let's do the autosave first. And here I need to change the text to an icon. But first I need icons for those. So let's see.